My staff, we keep involved in our kids' lives, trying to see, you know, did they make it home safely? You know, what did they eat tonight? You know, are they with their parents? Are they by their grandmother's house? So when you have a staff like that to really put that kind of effort in and really stick to it for 4 years, you know, it pays off. And that's why, you know, that's why when I really said that message, because that's key for me, is not only to see these kids do good on the football field, but do good in life. But in order to do good in life, they have to live. We have to keep them alive. We have to make sure that they stay on the right path, that they don't get caught up in the wrong crowd or around the wrong people. So, and we'll have a team meeting tonight. We'll have a team meeting today about 4 o'clock, and we're going to talk about the events, because the whole team was there. You know, we had just left out of study hall and went to support the basketball team. But, you know, a real unfortunate incident when two schools in McDonough 35 and the Cup come together to play a great basketball game, and less than 100 yards away is a shootout with senseless gun violence. You know, that's really unfortunate, and that's the thing that we don't want to see our kids on the road. We want to see our kids excel, not decline, not go backwards. We want to see our kids go forward. You know, that's the crazy thing about life, that we is human nature for us to always need reminders. But it's a good and bad thing, because it's bad that we have to keep reminding our kids that this can happen. But it's also good that we can remind our kids that they're doing the right thing too, that they're coming to school, that they can walk these halls and say, I'm a student athlete that called and I'm doing the right thing. So that's what we really want to keep preaching. This is not about state championships and wins and losses. This is about our society and how we can come together to stop these kind of things from happening. So it starts in high school. It starts with your teachers. It starts with your coaches. It starts with your counselors, because if we're giving them the right message, they're bound to listen to one of us. So if we're all saying the same thing, they're going to listen to all of us.